In this video, we will see a few useful settings in ClickUp. If you're not new to ClickUp, you can click on this timestamp to skip to the main content or use the chapters given below so you can get straight to the video. And if you're new to ClickUp, here's my 2 cents. If you're still on the fence, please start using it. I've provided the links below. No, ClickUp is not paying me to say this. Although I have an affiliate link, if you choose to use that, I might get something. But then they're not paying me to say all this because I have myself been using ClickUp since 2020, September, I guess. It has been a great game changer. I would definitely suggest please start using ClickUp. You won't regret it. So here's a list of useful settings in ClickUp that you came here for. Dark mode. In case you're wondering, my ClickUp looks different than yours. That's because I activated the dark mode and you can do too. Just come to this setting here at the bottom and click on this dark mode. So this activates dark mode across your entire workspace. But what if you just want to activate dark mode only for this sidebar? They have a setting for that as well. Click on this space sidebar settings and just say dark side, which is bar, dark sidebar. You activate that and only your sidebar will become dark in color. Favorite menu bar. One setting I really find useful is activating the favorite bar at the top if you have not done that already. Here's how you can do that. When you start, if you don't have this favorites already added, you will see that on the left side here. And let me unpin this to show you how this works, just like this one. So if you click on this, you'll see the favorites. And all you want to do is just click on this pin and this sits, and then this shifts its place to the top of your page. And this is where you can access favorites bar, where whichever page you go, you will always see this showing up. And truth be told, you should not be getting into all of these lists all the time. It will just keep you out of focus. If you want to just focus on few things, maybe for that particular day where you're working, I would say put those things into your favorites so that you can easily access all of this here immediately from any page. Of course, you need to add folders and lists to favorite for this to work. How do you add to favorite? Click on the drop downs and click on favorite. Next, we can link ClickUp to our calendars. Let's say Google Calendar or any Apple iCal, for example. When you schedule a task with due date and time, it beautifully gets transported to your calendar. This, I guess, is one-way sync. So here's how you can link your calendar, personal calendar, to ClickUp. Click on your workspace settings and just go to settings. And on the left side here, scroll all the way to the bottom and click on calendar. As you can see, I have already linked my Google Calendar here. So what this does is it's a one-way sync. Whenever I add a task with a due date, this gets synchronized with my Google Calendar. So I also start getting notifications on Google Calendar if I have that activated on my any of other devices. So that way I can also know that, okay, this task is due for this time. Unless you have, of course, ClickUp app also being used, that you'll also get the notification in your ClickUp as well. So if you don't want two different notifications, you can disable this calendar. But I think this will give you a clear-cut picture of what your calendar looks like. In case if you're not used to ClickUp's calendar, you can synchronize that with your personal calendar, and that way you can get to see your calendar upfront with ClickUp's tasks that you have added. Next in the list is finding more room on the screen. This sidebar may not be necessary to be open all the time. So whenever you want this collapsed, simply hit Q on your keyboard to collapse the sidebar. I found this super useful whenever there were more columns in my list. So I need not do the painful horizontal scrolling like this one, or use the scroll. Speaking of scrolling, did you know that you can use your mouse scroll wheel to see all the columns instead of clicking this pesky scroll bar that's hard to grab? The secret is to hold the shift key while scrolling. Next in the list is about creating tasks by email. Honestly, it's a lesser used feature unless you really want to create tasks through email. So here's how it works in case you're interested. So whenever you create new tasks by sending email to ClickUp, those tasks are created within the lists. And for every list, there is a unique email address that you want to copy. So first, you'll want to find the list where you will be adding new tasks. To do that, let me expand my sidebar again. Click on the ellipses next to the list where you want the tasks to be created. Let's say I want to add to the ideas here, then click on more, then say email to list. Clicking on this will give you the email address that you want to send email to. Copy this and add it to your address book, with which you can then send or forward the email to ClickUp to create tasks and attach your email to the tasks within this particular list. And once again, remember that this email address is unique to this list. And as you can see here, I'll throw this up on the screen as well. The subject that you give will be the task name, and you can assign this with this tag assign and then give a name if you have more members. And you can say due and then give the due date and time. And you can also add tags to it by including tag and then give the tag name. The body of the email will be the task's description. And if you attach any email attachments to that email, then that will be also attached to your task. Just remember that all your email attachments will also add to the storage within your ClickUp account. So that's how you can create tasks by email. The next on the list is a close cousin related to email. But here you can check and reply to your emails right within ClickUp. I found this really cool. Here's how to activate it. First, you'll have to enable your ClickApp called email. So let's do that. Click on that workspace settings and click on ClickApps. And in here, you can search for email and activate this. Once you do that, if you go to your workspace lists and then open any particular task, let me open a task. Now, this next step was not that obvious and it took some time for me to figure it out. I was expecting a new screen where we can also check emails and reply, but that's not the case. Once you open a task, you can see that when you type a comment to a task, you can see this can be sent as an email here at the bottom. So instead of a comment, you can send an email, and then from your email address that you have linked to your, in your ClickUp account, you can send it to someone, put the subject and say something and then send the email. And then the replies will also be tracked here. So that's how this email checking and replying for a tasks and lists work in ClickUp. If you're working with multiple members in your team, you need not leave ClickUp and check your inbox. So this way you can interact with them through email within ClickUp itself. That's where this comes specifically useful. If you're not into any of those and you are a one member team, then forget this feature. Next is about dashboards. Dashboards in ClickUp can be activated as a ClickApp first. So I want to go to the settings again and click on ClickApps. Make sure you have the dashboards activated like this one, this ClickApp. And once you do, you get to see your dashboards here. You can also hit the keyboard shortcut D to come there. And within dashboards, you can then add the widgets of your choice from the list, from this list here. Most of these widgets will come under the unlimited and business plans, but there are also some free ones that you can check out. But as an individual content creator, again, I didn't find this one super useful, except maybe this tag usage here. Let me know in the comments if you know of any usefulness within dashboards. The next in the list is about a time tracking ClickApp. Let's say you give yourself 25 minutes to complete a task. You can start tracking your task's time right here within ClickUp. Let's see how to do that. Activate the time tracking ClickApp, and once you do, you get this additional tool within every task in ClickUp. So all you want to do is you can start the timer when you start your task within ClickUp and track it as to how long it takes for you to work on. You can see that this is getting tracked over here at the bottom. And remember, once you're done with the task, make sure you stop the timer so you can see how long a task has taken for you to complete. So this one was 10 seconds. Of course, that's the shortest you can get. But once you do a task, you can see how long you take to complete a task. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you really liked it, then you might also like this one where I showed a few more settings, maybe 25, I guess, within ClickUp on how to use basically. So you can click that to watch it right now. Just click it.
See you there.